Hello everyone, and thanks for tuning into our Science on a Sphere Earth Day show. So to celebrate the 50th anniversary of Earth Day, we're going to be releasing a video every day leading up to Earth Day, talking about how scientists monitor the Earth. So today we'll be discussing satellites and their positions in space, and in the following days we'll talk about the different types of instruments satellites have, and what they can show us about the Earth. And I'll be showing you some pretty cool data sets of Earth as well. And we would love it if you would join us back for all of our Earth Day content. But so let's go ahead and get started. So you're seeing the Earth as it currently is. And what you're viewing the Earth through is an app that I have. So this is called the SOS Explorer app. It's free to download for both Apple and Android. So if you'd like, you can follow along. Like I said, that app is called the SOS Explorer app. So we're seeing the planet as it is currently. Here's North America. Here's South America. Africa, Europe. And then since this recording is happening in the morning, here's our day-night terminator. That's just that dividing line between day and night. And then over here we have Australia and Asia in nighttime. So this app is pretty cool. You can use it to study geography. So you can actually add in borders for states and countries and actually add their labels. So then, like I said, this is a pretty nifty app to help you study geography. But since this is our Earth Day show, we're gonna start off, and like I said, we're gonna take a look at our satellites. So this is our data set showing satellite positions. So there are approximately a little over 2,000 active and working satellites that orbit the Earth. Now this data set doesn't show all 2,000, but you can get a feel for just how many satellites we have orbiting the Earth. Now there are plenty more objects up in space that are not current active satellites, like rocket parts or other bits of debris, so keep that in mind as well. There are a lot of things orbiting the Earth, even if they're not active satellites. So like I said, this is just a snapshot, and even with not full 2,000 satellites, it's still a little crazy to look at. So we're not going to be taking a look at all of these satellites at the same time. We're going to be looking at certain orbits at a time. That way it's not quite so crazy. So here we are. So what you're looking at currently are what we call geosynchronous orbit satellites, or geostationary orbit satellites. So they orbit the furthest away from the Earth, about 22,000 miles above, and they orbit only at the equator. They don't have any varied orbits like some of the others do. Now, looking at this, they don't appear to be moving, do they? Not like the other ones. Not like these. That's because these follow the Earth's rotation, and they appear stationary in our sky, and that's where the term geostationary came from. Now, like the GOES satellites, which stand for Geostationary Operational Environmental Satellite, these are used by scientific government agencies like NASA and NOAA to observe the Earth, and a lot of our data sets that we have for Science on a Sphere actually come from GOES. And a lot of these other satellites, like EchoStar, Galaxy, these are all used for media and telecommunication. So one way that geostationary satellites are used here on Earth is should you have a cable dish attached to your house and that's how you get your cable, that dish is directed at a certain spot in the sky. So it's actually directed at a geostationary satellite, and that's how you get your cable because it doesn't move relative to here to us here on Earth. So those are the geostationary satellites. The next ones we're going to be taking a look at are the medium orbit satellites. They don't have a fun name. So the medium orbit satellites, they orbit about 12,000 miles above the Earth. They take about 12 hours to orbit. So about half the time of the geostationary ones, which take that full 24 hours. Now most medium orbit satellites are GPS satellites. They basically cover the entire Earth all the time because if you're using GPS, you don't want to lose your GPS connection. You want to be able to have that all the time. So that's why GPS satellites have these varied orbits, and that's why they seem to cover the entire Earth all the time. And then lastly, are our low Earth orbit satellites. So these orbit only 1,200 miles above the Earth. They're extremely close, and they only take about 1 to 2 hours to orbit the Earth. They zoom by pretty quickly. Now these are the satellites that are primarily used for scientific and weather purposes, so they have all those instruments that I'll be talking about later to study and monitor the Earth. Most of these are NOAA satellites, or the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. Like I said, these all study and monitor the Earth constantly. And another example of a low Earth orbit satellite, or LEO, as we like to call them, is the International Space Station. If I can track it. It moves pretty fast. It's very low in orbit, and it only takes about 90 minutes to circle the Earth. But it has lots of instruments to study the Earth, as well as to study space and astronomy as well. So like I said, most of our data sets that we'll be taking a look at later in the week, a lot of them will be coming from either these low Earth orbit satellites, these NOAA satellites, or the geostationary GOES satellites. I hope you tune in tomorrow for us to talk about hurricanes and how we're able to view and understand hurricanes when they come by. So thanks for joining us today, and hope to see you tomorrow